Hi guys, this is Jason here from Nathaniel. In this lesson, we are basically going to do a couple of things. It's going to be a little bit of theory and a little bit of application, of course, but most of it is theory and most of it is a way of understanding how chords and scales work together, hopefully from a new perspective, maybe for those of you who've just looked at building chords one way. Okay, so the traditional way of forming chords from a scale would be, you know, you take a D major and then you have all its available chords. Major, minor, minor, major, major, minor, diminished, major. So all of those chords came from the parent scale, in this case, the D major scale. Now, what if I told you that this whole equation could be reversed? The whole thing could be flipped over its head by saying that the chord will be the focal point of my composition. Maybe I could play this chord, which is a C major seventh. I will tell you all this shortly. And maybe we should find a couple of scales, or more than a couple of scales, which work well with this chord. Maybe or maybe if I take a dominant seventh chord, maybe another scale. Or maybe some other. Right? So depending on the chord, so now if I have this chord, you have a scale which goes with that chord, but then you could have quite a few scales. So in this lesson, I'm going to limit our study of chord scales to just one type of scale, or rather two types of scales, which both have one thing in common, that they have five notes. So what do we call five note scales? Pentatonic scales. So we have the major pentatonic scales and the minor pentatonic scales. Let's first look at the formation of the scales. So in this lesson, we look at the formation of all this stuff, how to form the scales very quickly, how to form the more fancy chords, which I call as seventh chords. Then we are going to start doing the chord scale relationship, what scales work with each chord, and then a few tricks of how to use the pentatonic scale over all of these chords to not only get a sound which works, but also get a sound which is very, hopefully, sophisticated, or as people say, very jazzy in nature. Right? So let's get cracking right away. Before we do, if you haven't subscribed, if you haven't hit that bell, go over and do the same. And the lesson is supplemented with a good number of notes for all these theory and technical things. There's notation, there's a lot of diagrams which are going to be shared with you. To get that, just go over to our Patreon. It's $5 a month, so you get your hands on pretty much everything we'll ever do on YouTube, in the writing, notes, if there's a backing track, if there's notation or whatever it may be, it will be there on the Patreon page. Head over there and it'll be great to have your support as well for our channel. Let's get cracking. Right, so first off, let's figure out how to get the pentatonic scales going. Major pentatonic is 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 8, which is the same as 1. 8, 6, 5, 3, 2, 1. Major pentatonic. Sa re ga pa da sa, sa da pa ga re sa. And to add flavor to the pentatonic, usually what people do, especially in a bluesy and jazzy context, you add the flat 3 along as a passing note, like sa re ga ga. That's the penta. Maybe on another video, I'll show you how to do fingering for this, because it can be a bit tricky if you go up and down the board. So let's build 3 pentatonic scales, and I would encourage you to do the rest. So for C, it'll be C, D, E, G, A, C, I, C, C, A, G, E, D, C. Got it? okay, coming to D. And a simple way to remember penta formation is if you know your major scale, just knock off the 4 and the 7. Job done. Knock off the 4 and the 7. So if I'm on D, D, 1, 2, 3, knock off the 4, which is G. Go to the 5, 6, don't want 7. Octave. It's also what I kind of call as like the anything goes scale. You can use it for so many chords. Kind of works for everything. So that's D major penta. Let's also do a flat scale penta, major penta, E flat. E flat can start with your index finger. E flat, F, G, B flat, C, E flat. E flat, C, B flat, G, F, E flat. See my fingers. Maybe not the ring there. Middle. It's easy to cross there. You come back, I guess ring is okay. D, C. There, figure out where to cross the thumb. And for the flat scales, don't start with your thumb. Otherwise, you'll have a huge trap there. Impossible. It's like the jail being given to your middle finger there. So index. And also be acquainted with the flat 3. There we have it. Okay, coming to minor pentatonics. Now, minor pentatonics have the formula 1, 3 flat, 4, 5, 7 flat, octave. Also derived from major pentatonics. Their cousins are the major pentatonics. So, bit more aggressive, and if you add the blues note, which is the tritone or the flat 5, makes it a lot more spicy. So C minor penta, 1, 3 flat, 4, 5, 7 flat octave. D minor penta. Okay. E flat minor penta. You can also build intervals with them, and a quick tip, F sharp. F sharp major penta is all your black notes on the keyboard. That's your F sharp major pentatonic. If you'd like to have some fun doing that, or play some of the old video game music which was there in the 90s, at least where I used to play video games. Quite cool, and you're just using the black notes. Or if you start with the E flat, you get the minor version, right? You'll find a lot of artists just composing on the black scales, like on these pentatonics. Like you take Stevie Wonder. Some of his greatest songs are on E flat. So Just some information for you. F sharp major penta, all black notes. E flat minor penta, all black notes. So that's about the two scales which we are going to learn for the lesson. Pentatonics, major, minor, with that blue note here and there. Let's now look at the chords which I'd like to use for this chapter, which are the seventh chords. I'm only going to do three of them for today's lesson. The major seventh, the minor seventh, and the dominant seventh. And the expectation from the lesson would be your left hand will probably be holding the major seventh chord and the right hand is going to explore a scale of which will work over it, like the pentatonic. Some pentatonic will need to happen in the right hand over your own improvised melody. I'm not going to show you any melody per se. It's just how you adapt to that chord. Okay? It's a very simple question if you think about it. You see a chord chart which has a chord at a given point in time, and you just ask yourself what scale goes with that chord. Now that seems a bit absurd sometimes, but it is true. You can have a unique scale for every chord. This is where people also look at the subject of modes. Now we have done a lot of lessons, theory lessons on modes, seventh chords, cadences, and the like, and most of those need to be watched by you, and a lot of advanced topics have already been covered. Also, we've done an entire chapter on blues music, so that'll also be a great foundation for things like jazz, which I plan to cover in the future lessons. Right, so major sevenths again, let me show you with respect to C. I'm going to teach you C, D, and also E flat. These are the roots I've chosen for the class. Why only do one root, right? So major seventh is nothing but root, third, fifth, major seventh, sa ga pa ni. So the third is a major third, fifth, seventh, minor seventh now, C, E flat, G, B flat, that's a minor seventh, dominant seventh, 1, 3 normal, major three, perfect fifth, dominant seventh. So major seventh, minor seventh, dominant seventh. Coming to D, D major plus seventh. So if you know D major, it's quite easy. You just add the C sharp, D minor with a minor seventh, then D major with a dominant. Okay, that's your D root, major seventh, minor seventh, dominant seventh. Now coming to the E flat root, major, major seventh, minor seventh, and the dominant seventh. So those are the chords which are being used for the lesson. Okay, so now coming to the general chord scale relationship, what scale do you play for each chord? Before I actually show you the point of today's lesson, which are on how you can use the pentatonic scales for the improvisation, let's look at some bigger parent scales first, just to give you some initial idea of what we are trying to gain in this lesson. Right, so if I take the major seventh chord, let me show you, demonstrate on C major seventh, which is here. Now, if you look at it, a scale which can be built through this, obviously four notes are known, which is, it's a given. Your scale will have the same notes as the underlying supporting chord. But this is just the root, the third, the fifth, and the major seventh. So you've committed to the 1, the 3, the 5, and the 7. But what about the others, which is the 2, also what we call as 9, if you play it along with the 7th chord, that's D, then you have the 4, which is in the C major, it's F, but F just doesn't sound so nice, it sounds a bit dissonant because there's a tritone created between B and F, and also C and B are very close to each other in isolation. So instead of that, to avoid that dissonance, people tend to like F sharp. As you can see, it's a very, very normal relaxing sound, right? Even though it is a tritone, by nature, if I expose it, it's a horror movie. But if I played with the major seventh, okay, you can do this, what we call as the, well, sharp 4, or more correctly, sharp 11. This will be the 9, and that'll also be your 13, which is the 6. If you think about it, if you play C major 7th, just with this, you compose a melody with just the chord notes. Sounds nice, but when you bring in the other notes, which we call as tensions, which is the 9, 11 sharp, 13, or 6 natural, starts giving you that very colorful or that jazzy flavor. So a great scale which works over the major seventh chord would be the Lydian scale. On that, and that's what I'm going to show you with the pentatonics. We are very quickly going to see how, just by knowing those scales really well, you can improvise nicely. Okay, coming to the minor seventh chord. So before that, major seventh, what scale generally should be within your radar? The Lydian scale, which is the major with a sharpened fourth. We don't call it flat 5, because then the 5 would be removed, right? Those work in some other scales. Sharp 4, because the 4 has been defeated. There's no F. It sounds a bit, as you can rightly hear, I guess, sounds a bit wrong or a bit weird. So that sounds usable. That's your Lydian sound, or the sharp 4 sound. Now, what do we do when we address a minor 7th chord? This is the sound of the minor. So the scale which works really well over this, again, you can build your scale with the chord tones first, which is your C, E flat, G, B flat. Then you have your 9. Then you have normal 11. That sounds a bit weird, right? So this sounds very nice, and then the flat 6 doesn't sound good, but the normal 6 sounds great. So that, and flat 7. So flat 3, natural 6, flat 7. That's what we call as the Dorian scale. So if you highlight the 9s and the 11 and the 13, again you get a very sophisticated jazzy kind of sound. So it's good to know not just the scale, but which notes of the scale sound consonant and which are the ones which sound colorful, or what we call as the jazz tensions, which are the 9, the 11 and the 13. So that's for your minor 7th bass. You see how the scale came from the chord, didn't it? Right? Now coming to the dominant 7th. So the dominant 7th is extremely cool because it allows for a lot of stuff. So at the bare minimum, you could build a scale which has these notes and the 9, 11, 13. Can do that, but it, so if I play the scale, it becomes what we call as the mixo or the mixolydian scale. Amazing. It works really well as a scale over that chord. But you can also consider intervals like the flat 9. Sounds quite nice. You could even consider the sharp 9. You can even consider the sharp 4 or the sharp 11. Or the flat 13. Or the augmented fifth. So you can build a lot of scales. You can go, that's a sharp 4, sharp 5, that's a Lydian augmented scale, which is really nice. Or you can just do Lydian with a flat 7. It's a Lydian dominant scale. You can add all those weird altered notes, as they call it, and build a scale with all that. Definitely, I'm diverting a bit, so more on these altered scales and all that, definitely in another lesson. And do leave your suggestions, because we've not done a lot of lessons on jazz and a bit more advanced theory. So if you have any suggestions on this front, do leave them in the comments. It'll be great. Right. So this is about the chords, the scales, and the relationship between the scale and the chord. Now coming to the actual piano trick, or the piano compositional tool, which I have for you in this lesson, which is using the two pentatonic scales in its simplest form, the major and the minor scale, over these three chords. And let's come up with as cool music as we possibly can. Let's move on. Right, so if I'm on C major 7th, the more normal sound which you'd want to go with, and mind you, we are only going to use pentatonic scales for this entire lesson, so, or rest of the lesson. So the pentatonic scale for C major 7th would be C major penta. We've written that down. Works really well. But the more jazzier option when dealing with a chord would be to play a pentatonic scale, but starting on another interval, or formed from another interval of the chord. So the first opportunity you can do is take the C major 7th and ask yourself, what is the perfect fifth of C? You'll realize the perfect fifth of C is G. C, D, E, F, G, Sa, Pa, Sa, C, G. And now play G major pentatonic in all its glory. So if there's a chord which you see, C major, C major 7, the initial habit for most musicians who've come up from a pop rock culture would be, okay, I see a C major printed there, let me jam on the major pentatonic. It's a very common sound, sounds great, but if you want something different, you can just say, okay, that guy is playing C major, what shall I do instead to make it more colorful? Go up a fifth, go to G. It works completely fine, and it's part of the bigger picture scale, because it has G. And now I'm giving you some of the colors. That's the 13th, 7th, 9th. Of course, chord tones. That's G, A, B, D, E, G, G, E, D, B, A, G. That's your pentatonic G scale. And if you want something even more jazzy or more colorful, you can start, just tell yourself, okay, C major 7th is my chord. Move up a 2, move up 2 steps to the major interval, major 2nd interval. What is 2 from C? D. And now jam on the D major penta, and this will be very, very colorful. It gives you that Lydian note. Could kind of wander point that you may not even like playing C anymore, you know, in your melody. That'll be quite cool. Okay, so then same story if you do D major penta. What are the relationships now? D major pentatonic works great. But then what did I tell you? You can move to a fifth. After doing the fifth, you can also move up a major second, which will be E, and then you play the E major pentatonic scale, giving you that Lydian flavor. Right? So, lot of options there, right? You have three scales to play over this one chord, D major 7th. Now, E flat major 7th, let's do one more. E flat major 7th, obviously E flat major penta works. You could also look at up 5, perfect 5th. So you need to map out all your pentatonic scales, very important, and figure out how to play them also on the piano. The fingers are very important in that regard. So go up a fifth, you get B flat major penta, then go up a second, you get the Lydian, right, over the E flat. The good thing about thinking that way is pentatonic is just 5 notes, so it's a simple memory tool, like it's just 5 notes, and if you just say 5 notes but you skip up 2 and play the pentatonic from the major second, and immediately it just gives you that sophisticated sound. So that's what you do over a major 7th chord. Let's now do the same drill a little bit more quickly, I guess, since you've kind of got the drill over the minor 7th chord. Right, so C minor 7th. So the same equation, if you want something normal, just play the normal minor pentatonic, C minor penta. Okay. If you want something more colorful or more jazzy, tell yourself, okay, I want to play some other minor pentatonic scales, again separated by a perfect fifth. So you go to G and play G minor penta, which gives you all those a few jazzy intervals, but may not be the 13 which you'll get from the other one. G minor penta could also start from the second, as we did for the major 7th chord as well, right? All the colors are there. 9, 11, 5 of course, 13. Okay, so C minor has those three scales. C minor penta, then you have G and D. Okay, let's move on to the next one very quickly. D minor penta. Okay, what are the scales? The obvious, the namesake scale. Then go up a 5. What is a 5? A. Then go up a 2. E minor penta. So D minor penta, A minor penta, E minor penta. Okay, now coming to E flat. E flat minor 7th in my left hand, and I go 9. E flat minor penta, all the black notes. Then you go up a 5th. B flat. Or you go up a 2. And the minor penta from the two. So that's about the minor seventh chord. Let's now move over to the last chord for this lesson, the dominant seventh chord. Right, so the dominant seventh chord has quite a few options. You have this normal sound, as I'm calling it. You have a jazzy sound, and you also have a very altered sound, like a sound which is like it's coming from somewhere else. So let's just try and build all the three over the dominant chord. The dominant chord is a very powerful chord. You can use all your intervals over that. So this is C7th. First off, there's something very interesting here. You can do C major pentatonic, works quite well. But there's something very funny. You can even play C minor pentatonic. So over a dominant seventh chord, you can perhaps play C major penta as well as C minor penta. C minor gives you more of the bluesy vibe. So that's a dominant. It's quite cool, isn't it? So whenever you see a dominant seventh, get used to that E flat over and that's the funny part. If you isolate the two notes, sounds horrific, right? But now it sounds extremely usable. So major context, major pentatonic context, minor, bluesy, right? If you want some of those jazzier intervals, remember for the dominant seventh, don't go up a fifth, go up a fourth. Go up a perfect fourth and play the major penta from the fourth. What is the fourth from C, F? Right? It's a very brightish sound. You get yourself the 11th, 13th, and the 9th. So it's quite colorful. There's another thing you could consider. This will be the final tip I want to make in this lesson, where you go up a tritone from the C, where you go. Even that seems to work. So if you go, it's an acquired taste. And what will make it sound even better would be to remove the fifth from your chord and make it either a flat five or a sharp five. So G, when you flat the five, it becomes F sharp. Now it kind of works. Or sharpen the G to A flat. So this is C7th with a sharp 11, right? Or you're flattening the 5th. This is the same C7th with a sharp 5 or an augmented 7th. So if you do those chords, then it creates this altered sound, as they call it. Altered sounds are the usage of the altered intervals, namely the flat 9, the sharp 9, the flat 5 or sharp 4, flat 13, and of course the flat 7. So look at your F sharp major pentatonic. It clearly gives you all those altered notes. So instead of maybe playing the full-on altered scale, you could consider to play just the pentatonic major. So let's revise everything on the dominant seventh again. So dominant seventh chord, play the namesake major penta and the minor penta. They both work. Minor penta, that bluesy edge which you get. Then something more jazzy would mean go up to the F, which is the 4. Or alter your chord by removing the 5th, play something like a flat 5 or a sharp 5. You know, and go up a tritone and play the major pentatonic from the tritone. Tritone of C is F sharp. So we've also prepared a nice chart for you to see how you can climb your intervals in the chart. I've put the major second of everything. I've put the perfect fifth of everything. The fourth is also there, and the tritone will also be there. So that should help you navigate. You can also look at the circle of fifths if you want to remember your intervals better, but you can start with the chart which we have printed for you, available on our Patreon page, which you can head over and not only get that, you'll get the entire notes from this particular lesson. So the writing work is a little bit deep for this lesson. You need to write a bit more, but that helps you plan. So by writing everything, shaping out all your scales, it will help you now navigate. So the whole intention of this lesson is, whenever you look at a chord, you're looking at C minor 7th, and you should immediately have an idea of what to do. In this case, I moved up a 5th to play G minor pentatonic, or I'm E flat minor 7th. What shall I do? Maybe F minor pentatonic. Maybe I'll now vamp on D major penta, move up a 2. Okay, or maybe something dominant. Go up a 4, or maybe alter one of those things and go up a tritone. Why did I do B flat? Because B flat's the tritone from E. So a little bit of writing is needed. Otherwise, I don't think you'll be able to visualize it immediately. Get a grip on your pentatonic scales. Get a grip on your major sevens, minor seven, dominant seventh chords. If you're having any doubts regarding any of this, do leave us a comment and I will get to it and consider a future lesson on these rather more difficult subjects, right? And thanks again for watching the video thus far. However, if you consider yourself a beginner, you can always consider either our piano foundation course, where we have videos which are in our members only directory. You can access them with a monthly subscription, or if you'd like to learn with me or with any of our other faculty at Nathaniel for vocals, violin, bass or whatever, you can fill up the form which is in the description and you can join one of our sort of in-person virtual courses where you'll be given regular assignments and a lot of things to help you grow. Okay, and there's always Patreon, as I mentioned earlier. And as always, don't forget to like the video. It really helps the video do well. So consider giving it a like. Leave us a comment with anything, something positive or some suggestion you might have or any feedback from the video. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already and hit that bell icon so that you get notified for anything we do in the future. Right, guys, thanks again for watching. This is Jason from Nathaniel. Cheers.